The martini. In movie terms, directors use this phrase to describe the last shot of the day while on set. The stories you are about to hear are true. Names have been kept the same to reflect the strange. This is The Martini.
This is Sam. He was so in love with her, but she was young, and so that put her off in a jam. Though she was sweet as a yam, she wanted to explore other options with a man, straight sending Sam into a rampage. And no matter what his fam says, he's lost without this woman and don't wanna live any damn ways. Now he's thinking if he ain't gon' live, she ain't gon' live, and the other man's mercy he ain't gon' give. This what love do, it cops a 38 snub too. Knock on your door and take somebody that used to love you, rub you the wrong way, then it's blood, true love through. She slugged one and he slugged two. Then on a rainy evening with a painy feeling, went to her home and looked in the window when Sammy sees them. The door's between her and the necromancer, and what you think is gonna happen if she answers?
Take a drink, it's more than what you think. I gotta let you know, don't plan on letting you go. But if you have to leave, that's where we'll end the scene. This is a martini. Last shots for you only.
Yo, this is Isaiah. I guess he was Isaiah. Ladies, man, not what I used to call him, the KCI player. Flying multiple chicks in, give the stick, then dismiss them. But something's gonna happen that'll twist him. He fell in love with a beautiful black woman, but he ended up having a couple problems with that woman. Talking to other men, did it behind his back on him. Facebook computer love crept on the Mac on him. Now he's salty, cause he found the woman he loved is faulty. He told her at the very beginning, don't you ever cross me. Now that she did it, he plans to do something unlawfully. Get a gun off the street because he was treated so awfully. One bullet for her, one bullet for him. Crimes of passion, ain't no more pulling for them. And the worst way we broke apart, it really hurts, lady. I'm gonna go, but yo, you got to go first, baby.
Take a drink, it's more than what you think. I gotta let you know, don't plan on letting you go. But if you have to leave, that's where we'll end the scene. This is the martini. Last shots for you only.
This is Brian. He was a rebel and stayed on another level and had no intentions of dying. He loved Kim a lot, above them was not, but a jealous ex-husband would love them to rot. I guess he loved Kim still, his only thoughts him, them, kill, cause he a coward motherfucker. On Christmas Eve, he broke in and waited in their house for hours, crazy motherfuckers. Brian pulled up with Kim and little Alyssa in the car and saw a shadow in the house from afar and said, wait. Got out the car, opened the gate, walked in the house, and a fucking ex sealed my nigga's fate. That was my best friend, bitch ass nigga. Walked out the house and shot Kim right in front of Alyssa. Then he saved the last shot for him. Blast, nigga, you better hope I don't go to hell, cause I'ma be on your ass.
Take a train, it's more than what you think. God let you know, don't plan on letting you go. If you have to leave, that's where we'll end this scene. This is the martini. Last shot's for you or me.
Executive producer
Travis O'Quinn,
associate producer
Dave Weiner and Ron Spalding,
project consultant, general management
Bob Grassi, Brian Shafton, and Ben Grassi.
Production assistants
Corey Lloyd, Glenda Cowan, Don O'Gwen, Corey Nielsen, and Brian Fraser.
Project management and publicity coordinator
Corey Lloyd,
and publicity by
Richie Abbott, Travis O'Gwen, and Aaron D. Yates, Tech Nine,
Lego,
Bob Lieberman,
Photography,
RW2, Art
Direction and Design,
Liquid Nine,
Marketing and Print Motion,
Britt and Kim Larry, Chris and Rooney,
Street Marketing,
Aaron Bean and Josh Rickard,
Internet Marketing,
Brad Morrow,
Creative Consultant for Strange Music,
my main man David Temple. Hey,
album score by
the vocals by me.
Kelly, baby.
This is the end of KOD.